Hello everybody, and welcome back to Let's Play Xanadu for the MSX. Now in the last part I showed you most of level 3, some of the things to keep in mind here. In the meantime, off screen I've been running around killing a bunch of monsters. I've cleared out the two small towers in this level, which are not very interesting, so I decided to do that off screen as well. The reason I'm coming back now is because the final tower for level 3 is a little bit bigger and there's a couple of things I wanted to show you in there. But before we go to the final tower, I think it's about time to collect some of our level ups. Again, before we level up, I'm going to waste a little bit of gold on keys because I figured I'm going to need a bunch more in the near future. I have a bunch of spare gold, I don't have anything really important to buy right now. So why not stock up on some more keys? I still have quite a few, 25 of them. But as we level up, they're just going to get more expensive, so why not just buy a couple? Now the thing I'm going to do is, before I buy these keys, is equip my another one of my bottles, just to reduce the cost a little bit. My charisma is 110, if you remember, and using this bottle it's going to be 220, which will give us a nice discount. So yeah, it's about two-thirds of what it was before. So that's worth it, I think. I think 20. Fuck it, we'll go for 25. That means we're almost out of gold again, by the way, but it does mean we have 50 keys, which should get us through the next couple of levels without having to buy more. So with that out of the way, let's level up now. I think I'm due a fighter level and a wizard level. Okay, so we have our fighter level. Oh, we actually got a second fighter level as well. And a wizard level. I might be due one more wizard level, but we'll leave that until a bit later. Will we? Yeah. I don't really need to upgrade it right away. I think we should be more than strong enough to fight the end boss now. Let me just equip my lamps again, just so I don't accidentally use one of our valuable bottles. And we'll go find the final tower for this level. And I'll leave the lampreys again because they drop poison, which will be useful to us later, maybe. And this is the last tower for this level. Clearly it's one of the bigger ones, although the outside doesn't always represent the inside very accurately. But we'll see. Okay, let's go in. Now I happen to know that there's nothing on the left side, so I'm going to go straight to the right. I'm just going to get rid of these Grimlocks right away. I don't think they drop any items, but because we got a little bit lucky, I'll save the last one and kill him with my axe. But you know what, we'll do that on the way back. I'm not going to walk all the way back there. This is quite a big tower, so I'm going to try and get to the boss in a relatively short amount of time. Now there is something special about this tower, which we've seen a little bit in previous towers, but not that much yet. And that is that some of these rooms are booby-trapped. And that's the reason why I'm moving very carefully into the next room here, because I'm not exactly sure which rooms they are. And here's the first one. As you can see, they drop a poison bottle right in front of the entrance of this room, which means that if you're not paying attention, you're almost guaranteed to pick it up. In this case I was careful, so I managed to avoid it. Now the way we get past this guy is by shooting it with our magic spell. Items can be destroyed by shooting them with targeted spells, which is one reason to keep your needle spell even if you get a Dagmitar or something. And again, I'm just going to move very carefully each time I swap into the next room, because it's very easy to pick up one of those poison things by mistake. Oh, Lizardmen. Lizardmen again have a very strong spell, so I'm going to use my Dagmitar to get rid of them as soon as possible. And hopefully they won't be able to hit me before I kill them. And there goes one spell, but it'll be blocked by the other guy, so I should be safe. Lizardmen, I don't think, drop anything of value anyway, so it doesn't hurt to just take them all out at once. If I'm not mistaken, these guys would have dropped a spectacle, so yeah, not worth getting damaged for. Keep on moving. Now, from this level onwards, you'll notice that there's a lot more empty rooms in these towers. And in this case, I think the idea is to just give you a false sense of safety, so you end up running into those poison bottles. I'll leave you for the way back as well. Again, be very careful each time we swap, because all it takes is just one moment of losing concentration and you're poisoned. Oops, oh yeah, Grimlocks are immune to needle, that's right, because they use it themselves. Oh, not gonna bother swapping out my spells. I'll just hit them with my axe. Red potion, always nice. Now, I haven't used a lot of red potions so far, but with the boss on the end of this level, I might. I'm not entirely sure, but he might be strong enough to come close to killing us. So, even though they don't heal much, it's like 1500 or so hit points, it might be enough to save us. Again, very carefully moving into the next room. Here as well. Ah, beholders, okay. For the beholders, I am going to equip my Dagmitar because, like in the last part, I really don't want to get shot by these guys. Although I think these were the weak versions, so it wouldn't have mattered much. But better safe than sorry. Especially if you're about to fight a boss guy, because you really, really don't want to start that with low hit points. This tower is pretty big, so we might actually have to move the boss fight until the into the next part. Okay, I guess we'll see. See, with all these empty rooms, it becomes really, really tempting to to just keep running straight ahead, but the minute you do, you end up picking up a poison bottle. I should have been careful there too, because blooming sometimes drop poison. So I wasn't really being very careful. Now I believe the moment we started heading back, I think we're running into more beholders, so yeah, let's get rid of these guys immediately. Now one thing you can do in towers, which you can do in the big map, kill your enemies and then run away before their spell hits you, because the chests will actually remain on screen. If you leave a combat, leave combat with chests remaining in the overworld map, they disappear, but in the tower they'll just stick around until you pick them up. Oops, see, I wasn't being careful there, so if there had been a poison bottle there, I would have been poisoned right now. Some more thunder herders. I don't think, yeah, these are the item ones, so I'm not going to magic these away, but we'll see in the on the way back. And again, poison right here. Get that out of our way. Right, okay, so at this juncture, on the left is a couple more monsters, but the end boss is to the right, so I'm going to head straight there. Hopefully I'll be able to kill him before our time runs out. Now there is something slightly disappointing about the end boss for level 3, and that is that it's another Kraken, so unfortunately we won't get to see any cool new boss guys, sadly. I think level 4 has another one, but I'm not sure. Some more little caterpillar things. These are the gold types, but we're not looking for gold right now, we're looking for the boss. Oh, that's right, we get a free hammer as well, so +10 strength for us. think this is actually the entrance to the boss room. So yeah, before we start, let me equip my magic, although I'm not even sure if it can hit him. Probably not. And we'll equip our red potion just in case we get low on health. Here we go. It's a slightly different Kraken than in the first level, but it looks exactly the same. I was hoping it doesn't kick our ass. Actually, it might. No, well, yeah, we got him. That wasn't nearly as bad as I thought. And that's that. Level 3 is now clear, or as good as. Our reward is 3 keys. Keys are always valuable, of course. We have 2 gloves as well for experience with our weapon. We don't really need it with our axe at this point, I don't think. Yeah, our axe was already maxed out, but whatever. And 2 for our mitar spell as well. Now we have 2 special items here that you haven't seen before. The crown. You know, I'm not even exactly... I don't think I even remember exactly what the crown does. I do remember what the mushroom does. If you look at our hit points, we are now at 49,000. After we pick up the mushroom, we are at 53,900. So what it does, it adds 10% to your maximum hit points, which of course is very nice, and this is also the reason why I leveled up before we came here. Just so, we'd maximize our profits from the mushroom. I'm going to stop recording just for a second, just to see what the crown does. I'll be back in one moment. Okay, I'm back. Yep, I remember now. The crown is a special item that doesn't actually give you any boost or anything, but as you can see in my status here, the CRN in the green has ticked up to 1. And there's, if I'm not mistaken, there's 4 crowns in total in this game. And you need to collect them all to find the final boss in the final level. So it doesn't really give you anything, but you have to collect all 4 of them. Okay guys, I think that's about it for this video. I'm pretty close to 15 minutes. I'm just gonna walk back out of this tower, and I will probably move on to level 4 before I start the next part. In any case, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Hey guys, just a little extra for this video. I just wanted to show you one of the rooms in this castle, and this is actually true for the other 2 castles as well in level 3, are populated by these weenals, which is really annoying because they have some good items in them. But if you watch the bonus video from last round, you really, really don't want to kill these guys. So, as you can see, I'm walking around very, very carefully here to grab the items without damaging any of these little ghost guys, because again, they will give you karma, and that will make leveling up very difficult. So just wanted to show you that real quick, and that's it for this one. I'll see you in the next part.